Jesus talks about, he offers his followers a kind of test for how to discern false prophets. And he says, by their fruits you will recognize them. Mm-hmm. A good tree bears good fruit, and a bad tree bears bad fruit. And a good tree cannot bear bad fruit, and a bad tree cannot bear good fruit. And the Bible talks about what the fruit of the Spirit looks like in the book of Galatians. So love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control, those kinds mm-hmm. of things. Those are the types of traits that we see in many same-sex relationships today. Conversely, when LGBT people are rejected by their churches, by their families, that doesn't lead to the fruit of the Spirit as the Bible describes it. It leads to profound devastation, isolation, harm, pain, suffering. If the teaching that all same-sex relationships are sin is producing bad fruit, the teaching itself may be a bad tree.
I think the most rhetorically and emotionally powerful argument is the claim that in Matthew 7, 15 through 20, Jesus says, you'll know a prophet, so to speak, by its fruit. So a good tree produces good fruit, a bad tree produces bad fruit. Look at the teaching, the historic Christian teaching about sex and marriage, and look at the depression, loneliness, and attempted suicide of many people with same-sex attraction who try to follow this teaching. Therefore, the teaching must be false. That has emotional power because myself and nobody watching this wants to contribute to somebody's suffering. But the question is, what is Jesus actually teaching in Matthew 7? If you look at the verses before and you look at the verses after, good fruit is not somebody's experience in trying to live out biblical teaching. That's not what good fruit is. Rather, good fruit is obedience and bad fruit is disobedience. So if you give a certain teaching and it causes somebody to stray from biblical truth, that's bad fruit and it's a false prophet. We are not called to judge biblical teaching by how difficult it is to live out. Can you imagine if our standard on marriage and divorce or somebody who's hooked on pornography is like, man, it's so hard, I can't stop. Well, no. We don't judge biblical teaching by how difficult it is to live. Matthew 7 says you judge biblical teaching if it encourages people to be obedient or if it encourages to be disobedient. So ironically, when this argument is made, they're actually encouraging people in the name of good fruit to be disobedient and produce bad fruit, the exact opposite of what this passage is teaching.